Everyone, happy Thursday, happy afternoon. Ride on. Let's see. Today I wanted to just post a quick video about the ACT and what I learned from getting a perfect score, earning a perfect score on that test in high school. The first thing I learned was that it boosted me up into a higher echelon of schools that I was applying to all of a sudden. I don't want to list names, but suddenly I was applying to much better schools than I was intending to apply to. Number two, I got scholarships, and scholarships are really helpful for when you're going to college. College is expensive, and the one I went to, if you didn't get a scholarship, it's like 50 grand a year. So I got the highest scholarship offered besides a full ride at University of Denver, and I wouldn't have been able to go there, or I wouldn't have chosen to go there if they didn't give me that scholarship, and that's a major perk, especially if you're paying for school yourself. I wasn't, but I did in grad school, and I wish I'd gotten a scholarship to that. Number three, I got acceptances. When I was applying to college, I got accepted to every school I applied to except one. I think I got waitlisted at Colgate College. Everywhere else I got accepted, and so that was the next thing I learned. Number four, I learned that book smarts, while they are valuable, they're only valuable if you apply them and use them. So I went many years with these book smarts, but I didn't study as hard as I should have, maybe in college, or I didn't apply myself. I didn't start reading books from cover to cover regularly until lately, and I realized how valuable my book smarts are just to be able to understand what I'm reading and comprehend and analyze and reason through them. But it doesn't mean anything if you're not using that skill. If you know how to read but you don't do any reading, it doesn't do you any good, really. Number five, this is more about AP tests than ACT, but scoring well on tests can buy you things. For me in college, I scored well, and I got fives on at least on language for Chinese and on math for AP calculus, and it bought me out of taking math in college and language in college, not even a single course, so I could take credits in other more interesting or take some electives, like drawing class. I recommend everyone takes a drawing class in college. It's great for your brain, and it's a great way to be creative, and it really just makes you feel happy. So take classes that you might not need, but that push you in an area that you're not used to being pushed in. For example, art, philosophy, or something like that, anthropology. And you could even try taking upper level courses that you're not necessarily qualified for. I took anthropology and archaeology offered at the graduate level. It's a graduate school course while I was a senior in college, and it was one of the most interesting courses I took. And if you're trying to take a drawing class in college and you have no experience with art, you're terrible at art, you're in the same boat I was in. I didn't know what I was doing. They sat us down the first day and told us to draw our hand, or I think that was what they had us draw, and it was the hardest thing ever. It was so hard that I was and I was surrounded by people who were like art majors and stuff, that I was thinking about dropping the class. But this was an intro drawing class, and I stuck with it, and it was the best thing I ever did for myself in college. I think it met like for an hour and a half a couple times a week, and it was, I always looked forward to it. But yeah, you don't really need any art experience to do intro drawing, and you don't need to consider yourself a good artist. By the time I was out of it, I was drawing, making photorealistic drawings with charcoal, and with pastel, chalk pastels, and I couldn't even draw the backside of my hand when I first got there. And lastly, my high test score, at least at the university I went to, it helped me find people who were like me. My couple of my roommates in college, one was named Mickey, one was named Sam, and they had both gotten into UCLA based on, I think they're based on their ACT scores in high school. And one of, a couple of my best friends from high school went to UCLA, and it made me realize that like these are people who are similar to me and probably have similar enough interests and can relate to me on different levels. And so that was the final thing I learned. So go out there, take your tests, do your best, take your AP classes, take the AP tests, do your best, and you'll get rewarded, and it'll give you confidence, it'll open doors for you, but you have to apply what you, apply the skills in order to get the benefits as well. Alright guys, peace out, have a good afternoon.